Hey YouTube, welcome back to a brand new Animal Crossing New Horizons video. Today we're taking a look at the latest seasonal crafting material to be added to New Horizons and all of the corresponding mushroom furniture items now available to craft. So without further ado, let's get straight into today's video. So the spooky season is now over, as today marks the start of the end of autumn, with November being the final month of the season. Thankfully, there's still plenty to be getting on with November introducing a bunch of changes to the New Horizons Island. One of the most significant changes is of course a brand new set of crafting materials and their corresponding DIY recipes. Starting from the 1st of November, the Northern Hemisphere will see all new mushrooms spawning around our islands for the first time. These mushrooms include the skinny mushroom, the flat mushroom, the round mushroom, the elegant mushroom, and finally, the rare mushroom. From today, all of these mushrooms can be found growing on the ground around our islands, although some are rarer than others, and surprisingly, it depends on your island's rating to which mushrooms have a higher chance of spawning. Now, these mushrooms typically spawn near trees and tree stumps, with the exception of the rare mushrooms which, although still spawn near trees, actually grow underground. Now, just like previous crafting materials such as the cherry blossom we saw back in the spring, or the acorns and pine cones that can still be found around our islands now, all five of these mushroom types are a seasonal material and are only available for a limited time. The good news is every mushroom will be around for the remainder of the autumn season and will continue to spawn until the 30th of November as we start to transition into the winter season. So plenty of time to hunt for as many mushrooms as we're going to need. Anyway, as you now know, all of these types of mushrooms are a crafting material and can be used to craft limited time mushroom themed furniture items, which I think is the perfect way to bring the autumn season to a close. However, just like pretty much most of the limited time furniture in the game so far, we have to find and learn the DIY recipes before we can craft them. Fortunately, we're all experts by now and they're easy to find. Throughout the remaining days of autumn and up to the end of the month, mushroom DIY recipes can be found in the Northern Hemisphere in balloons, message bottles, and from island residents. For the new players out there, the balloon presents float across our skies every 5 to 10 minutes. Apparently, there's a 15% chance the present will include a seasonal DIY recipe if shot down, although this is different for every player and we don't know the exact drop rates. Now, message bottles are just like balloons except they wash ashore and land on your beach. You're guaranteed to find at least one bottle per day, but bonus bottles can also be found on Mystery Island tours. Each bottle is guaranteed to include a DIY recipe, so depending on how many recipes you've already learned, there's a good chance this will include a mushroom one during November. And finally, any villagers you see crafting inside their houses can also offer up these recipes. Just remember, you can find a maximum of 3 different villagers crafting per day, which is super handy. Now, finding DIY recipes during a seasonal event usually ends up with getting a bunch of duplicates before finding them all. So a good tip is to save any you find so you can trade them with friends or others who may have duplicates of the recipes you're looking for, because it can be quite annoying trying to track that last recipe down. Now, before we take a look at all of the available items, if you want to keep track of the recipes you've learned so far, simply open the Nook phone and check the seasonal tab in the DIY Recipes app, as it lists any recipes you already know, so it's pretty useful. Anyway, moving on, we're going to be taking a look at pretty much all of the mushroom furniture available over the next couple of weeks, so maybe a bit spoilery for some players, so just bear that in mind. So, some of the mushroom furniture items we can craft include the mush table, the mush lamp and log, the mush partition, which I think is secretly everyone's favourite, the mush parasol, the mush low stool, the mush wreath, wand and umbrella, and finally the interior items, the mush wall, and forest flooring. So yeah, that's pretty much all of the seasonal furniture items that can be crafted with the new mushrooms that are now spawning around the New Horizons Island. It's worth mentioning that Isabel gifts you your first mush recipe in a morning announcement, typically when she's announcing mushrooms can now be collected. Don't worry if she hasn't given it to you yet though, as sometimes it takes a few days depending on other events and news happening on your island, such as campers or villagers moving out or new villagers who have just moved in and things like that. Of course, we can still find acorns and pine cones and their corresponding trees bounty recipes right now, so it's recommended to collect as many mushrooms as you can as soon as they spawn. Plus, an additional seasonal crafting material called maple leaves is due in mid-November too, and the last thing you want to be doing is collecting acorns, pine cones, 5 different types of mushrooms and maple leaves all in the last couple of weeks of autumn if you're trying to complete all the sets. Now, this is obviously only relevant to the Northern Hemisphere as the Mushroom series was available during the autumn, just after the launch of the game for players in the Southern Hemisphere. The good news is Young Spring Bamboo and those seasonal recipes are still available until the end of the month, so it gives both hemispheres quite a lot to find and craft before we change seasons. But what do you think about this mushroom furniture? Are you a fan of the items available, or are you not really bothered? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Anyway, for now, that pretty much wraps up this video. If you're an Animal Crossing fan, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any New Horizons news. Until then, I'd like to give a special thank you to this channel's Patreon supporters, as well as this channel's members. You guys absolutely rock and truly help me upload as regularly as I do. I couldn't do it without you. Don't forget to head over to our Discord server too. And of course, if you made it to the end of the video, please comment mush. Just let me know you did, that would be super awesome. And please be sure to include which mush item is your favorite. I'd love to know. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it entertaining. Please be sure to leave a like if you did. Thanks for watching. I hope you have an amazing day. Stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video. Peace.